यथा शिखा मयूराणाम नागानाम मणयो यथा तद वेदांग शास्त्राणाम गणितम मूर्ध्नि वर्तते. मैथमेटिक्स इज द क्वीन ऑफ ऑल साइंसेस एंड कंप्यूटेशनल थिंकिंग इज द हार्ट ऑफ दिस क्वीन. गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. आई मिसेस कल्याणी मोरोणे एंड माय कलीग मिसेस स्वाति फटिंग फोकसिंग हाउ मैथमेटिक्स लर्निंग इज एंजॉयबल फॉर एवर with computational thinking. Can computational thinking skill help to solve math problem? When it comes to complex mathematical concepts, can computational thinking help to understand these concepts? Let us see how our children developing problem solving skills through computational thinking. Any complex problem in any walk of life can be solved by systematic approach of decomposition. CS Pathshala lessons have enriched the student learning process and the teacher's development. Meghe Group believes in innovations, and School of Scholars is institution which nurture every child to become scholar in future. It established in 1987. An integration with math and computer started since 2018. Children learn basic counting in their primary classes. The CS Pathshala lessons on counting reinforce the counting techniques through systematic approach. Another lesson on combination of clothes beautifully explain the concept of combination through daily life example. The lesson on arranging the different colored bricks help children to count the number of combinations under multiple conditions. So, counting combinations with number was easier for them. They were asked to solve this question. You are given 3 digits, 7, 2 and 9. How many 3-digit number can be formed without repeating any of them? Children followed the systematic approach. And since the condition is the digits cannot be repeated, they started with any of the given digits and they put it in hundreds place. Then they arrange remaining digits in tens place and ones place. This was their first combination. The another combination was formed just by interchanging the ones place digit with tens place digit in first combination. And when these steps were repeated with the remaining 2 digits in hundreds place, they got all 6 combinations with given condition. Another question was, a cycle stand vendor gives the tokens for cycle parking to students from 1 to 100. Find the number of tokens having digit 8. This problem taken from AMTI examination to make the strong building foundation of problem solving. They solve with systematic approach. They listed all the numbers from 1 to 100. Then they marked the numbers having 8 in ones place. They found 10 such combinations. Then they mark the numbers having 8 in tens place. Again they found 10 more combinations, but 88 was already counted. Hence they got total 19 combinations a cycle stand vendor can give.
Know that in mathematics, word problem solving is the challenge for students. Here, such a problem which becomes simple by applying abstraction of computational thinking. Students of grade 6, that is the age group of 11 or 12 years, were given a problem. Students were instructed to read the problem carefully and write it down what is given and what to find. Search the number. Identify the keyword, and depending upon the keyword, note the operation. Since the total people in Gitanjali is to be found, so student come up with the abstraction that the people get down is subtracted and the people boarded are added. Now, this is the problem. We can see that with the keyword and notified operation, the students are successful to solve the problem and they are able to find how many passengers are there at the Bhusawal station in Gitanjali Express. Now, the next problem, the problem of algebra, the word sum of algebra, students feeling little complex. Children were able to solve the word sum with the number systematically looking for keyword and notifying the operation that we have seen in the previous problem. Here, the numbers are replaced by polynomial. The transition for student was very easy. It is the best example of abstraction. This polynomial can represent anything like money, pens, chocolates. Due to abstraction, the complex problem become easy and students are able to find the answer with the keyword spent means subtraction and added means addition. Now, abstraction invites students to identify important information, ignoring unrelated details. Abstraction is the methodology. It makes students to think. Dear friends, actually, natural inclination of student to explore and play, to make strong building foundation of mathematics, exploration of problem solving helps student in math curriculum and beyond the textbook. The computational thinking encourages playful thinking but gives the structure and the student learn to solve complex problem with ease. We have blended computational thinking with our maths curriculum and we can observe that students are eager to participate. They becoming enthusiastic learner. They are solving the problem systematically. They are overcoming the fear of math, taking more interest in non-routine problem solving in maths club. As we all know that tests differ and change over time. So dear friends, it's time to change and make the student learning more enjoyable forever with computational thinking. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon, one and all present here. I, Swati Dange, with my co-teacher Rohini Deshmukh and Shilpa Patil, presenting a topic, A Steps Towards Happy Learning. A short introduction of our school. School of Scholar Amravati is CBSE affiliated school, started in 2004. We have 2,800 students learning of upper middle class and 92 plus teachers working here for first to 12th standard. We are implementing CS Pathshala since 2017-18 in curriculum for maths first to 7th standard, for computer first to 9th standard. We have adult tinkering lab in which students are working for different projects. We know an algorithm is a set of instructions which when followed to solve the problems or accomplish the required tasks. In computer class, children learn what is an algorithm, how to put the steps of algorithm in sequence. They also choose the best alternative from the different algorithms they develop. For example, going to movie. The students came up with the different alternatives. From there, they tried to create an algorithm. For example, they can go by car, they can go by bus, they can go by walking according to the feasibility of the transport. Here is an example of our school.
Algorithm help a lot while dealing with the problem solving in mathematics. So we applied algorithm in maths concept. Here are some of these concepts. Multiplication and division, LCM and HCF, addition and subtraction of fractions, tic-tac-toe, even and odd numbers, ascending and descending order of numbers, and guess my verdict. Multiplying with a single digit number is comparatively easy. Some students face difficulty when multiplying by two digit or three digit number.
For such a multiplications, we use algorithm steps. Children were asked to first multiply by 1's plus digit value, then multiply by 10's plus digit and append a 0 to the product. Then multiply by 100 plus digit and append 2 zeros. Now add the 3 products to get the final product. Student tried many multiplications with 2 digit and 3 digit numbers one by one in the class by following these algorithm steps. To encourage them, we had a competition among 2 students at a time in the class, and one those who will follow all the steps correctly was declared the winner. They enjoyed multiplication by algorithm very much. For long division, algorithmic steps were interlinked with the family members, which helped them to remember the steps like dad for dividend, mother for multiply, sister for subtract, brother for bring down, and Ramu uncle for remainder, and last step was checking. So this made students excited and motivated them to do many long division problems. Many students have a confusion when it comes to finding HCF and LCM of a number. We use the systematic steps to let them calculate and it become an algorithm. So to find LCM, student would find the multiples, then find the common multiples, and then find the least common multiples. Similarly to HCF.
Addition and subtraction algorithm. When student follow the systematic procedure to add or subtract 3 or 4 digit numbers, they get the correct answers. Here is an algorithm that they use to add 3 and 4 digit numbers.
Hello everyone, I am Vishenu Kamandri of School of Scholars of the Standard 5th Sense. Going to tell you the algorithm for addition of 4 digit numbers. Let's see the algorithm. Let's see this with the example. This we have done. Now, this is 1 plus, this is 10 plus, this is 100 plus, and this is 1000. So, we will start adding from the 1's place. So, 7 plus 12 equal to 12. So, in this, we have to carry. So, here, I will write 12, 2 of the 12, and 1 will be 6. So, it means we have to add this with the along with the carry. So, it means 9. Now, if the carry is added, we need to repeat the step 3 of forwarding the carry. So now we will similarly do the step also. So it is very easy to get the sum of 4 digit numbers by using of algorithm. Thank you.
Learn with fun Lagori. Children learnt various concepts through Lagori. Lagori is also called as 7 stones, pittu or the lingrocha, is oldest and most popular game in the India. My student follow all these rules. They played girls versus boys team and developed the winning strategies. They also learned the descending order concept through this game. Any number of people can play it. It required the 7 flat small stones. The size of each stone should be the less than the other. Keep all that stones in the descending order, hit the pile with a ball from a fixed distance. My student followed the rule, they enjoy it very much. The rules are, make a heap of 7 stones in the center. From the center, take around approximate 8 feet distance to throw the ball. One team will bat, one team will field. One of the player of the batting team will throw the ball and one of the player of the fielding team will stand to catch the ball and others will spread on the ground. Batting team can't cross the boundaries, otherwise they are out. Now player will throw the ball. Aim of the batting team is to arrange the stones back in the descending order and shout Lagori. And the aim of the fielding team is to hit the ball to anyone of the player of batting team. Fielding team can't run with the ball having in the hand. They can pass the ball to their teammates. If the batting team is able to arrange the pile in the descending order, they will get the 1 point and there all the teammates who are out will alive again. If the fielding team is able to hit the ball to any one of the player of batting team, whole batting team will out and the fielding team will come to bat. The team which score the 7 point first will be the winner. Students loved to play the games. The CS Pathshala lesson on tic-tac-toe was conducted fun quizzes in the classroom. Children even played it on the ground. When they started playing the game well, they could think of the winning strategies also. I would like to mention here, not only the bright student participated, but the shy ones also participated and enjoyed it in the classroom as well as on the ground.
It's my number.
So here the set of instructions were given to the students that write first n natural number, cross all the composite numbers, and my number is the successor of first composite number, and after that they have to guess my number. So student followed all these examples. They have written the 10 natural numbers, then they cross out the composite numbers, and then the third instruction was the number is the successor of the first composite number. So first composite number was here 4, and the successor of that 4 is 5. That was my number. So here student identified my number. In the
here student enjoyed the activity and understood how to systematically remove the unwanted number to guess the required number. Next, I conducted the online class activity guess my birth date. Here student asked me some questions to guess my correct birth date. Each question they asked would remove some numbers from the date of months, and they could guess my correct birth date after few questions. Here student used a systematic approach of cutting strategy for guessing the unknown birth date. Student enjoyed this activity very much, as well as due to this, the concept of maths like natural number, composite number, even an odd number, comparing numbers, etc. All these concepts get revised.
Creating algorithms for problem solving enhances understanding and problem solving skills, which leads to reduction of maths phobia, not only in physical school but also in online school. Here are some examples of students' algorithm who has developed according to their interests. This is an example of 6th standard student who has developed algorithm for how pilot should take a safe flight. This is an example of one more student who has developed algorithm how money should withdraw from bank. This is an example of a student who has developed algorithm how farmer works in field from preparation of soil to transportation of grain. Creating algorithms for problem solving enhances understanding and problem solving skill, which leads to reduction of a maths phobia, not only in physical school but also in online school. In multiplication and division, students to break down complex problem into simple problems, that is decomposition. In even and odd concept, they use colors pattern, that is pattern recognition. In even and odd concept, students to identify important information, that is abstraction. Lastly, using algorithm, students solve addition and subtraction. Algorithm help our students to take a steps towards happy learning. Whenever they came across any problem, they start thinking about the solution in steps. Computational thinking is a great way to open children's minds. CS Pashala motivated our children's and give us such a wonderful platform. Thank you, CS Pashala.
Thank you, MGS. Thank you, School of Scholars Amravati.
Thank you, everyone.
Hello everyone, my name is Ankita. I teach Computational Thinking and ICT at SES Gurukul Pune. I have a total experience of 4 years in teaching ICT, and I have taught in both IGCSE as well as CBSE boards. Before starting, I would like to thank CS Parchala for giving me this opportunity to talk about my experiences while teaching Computational Thinking. So, to start, the total number of students in our school is 632, and there are 10 classes with 2 sections each. The number of teachers teaching computational thinking in our school is 6, and we have 1 period per week dedicated for teaching computational thinking for each class. So, for teaching logical thinking and programming to the students through ICT, we have been using Scratch and Python. We teach Scratch from classes 6 to 8, and I think it is a very good tool for learning programming at primary and intermediate level. It is a fun way of learning how to code because it is completely visual. Children can actually see how their program is changing at each level by rearranging certain blocks of codes. They can create games, quizzes, animations. They can build their own stories through Scratch. When I joined Gurukul almost 2 years back, our principal Seema ma'am gave me an objective to integrate other subjects with ICT so that children are able to learn certain concepts in a fun way which they otherwise find boring or difficult to understand. So I thought that Scratch would be a good way to teach some topics from other subjects, as it is easy to learn and understand, and children would also take a lot of interest in it. But the challenge for me was to convince other subject teachers to integrate their subjects with Scratch. When I went and spoke to the teachers about it, initially they were a little doubtful about it, as they were all non-IT teachers. They did not have much idea about Scratch or, for that matter, any other sort of programming. So I decided to conduct a small workshop for them and showed them some projects done by the students. Once they all agreed with my idea, the next challenge was to identify the topics that should be taught to the students through Scratch. Some of the topics that we integrated were the two-dimensional coordinate system from maths, simple electric circuit from physics, we made quizzes from certain topics of social studies, we made different sorts of spirals which were very useful in teaching angular geometry and understanding how loops work. Now, let's take an example of our first topic, the 2D coordinate system and why we chose it. Sometimes, it becomes difficult for the students to learn the coordinate system of maths through graphs. Not all children are capable of understanding such mathematical concepts theoretically. They require a much more practical approach to understand such topics. So, through this coordinate plane, the teachers explain to the students about the x and y axis and how the position of the object placed anywhere on the plane changes when it is placed or moved to a different part of the plane. This is the program that we used for teaching 2D coordinate system, which we named as the Flying Witch and Hearts. In this program, we have to move the witch horizontally and vertically on the screen using the arrow keys, and we will win a score if the witch eats the hearts that are randomly appearing anywhere on the screen. So, the students will be able to move the witch on the stage only when they have a clear understanding of the x and y coordinates and how they have to change the x axis to make the witch fly horizontally and how they have to change the y axis to make the witch fly vertically. Expectations were completely met as all of them were able to make this game on their own. All of them looked very happy after completing the program. It would not have been possible for them to make the game on their own if they were not clear of the coordinate system. It was a delight to watch them working cooperatively and collaboratively. It also helped them immensely in understanding how motion works in programming. And as for the teachers, now they are aware of Scratch. They now know that they have an alternate method to teach some concepts practically, which are otherwise difficult to explain theoretically. Following is a small video in which Manjusha ma'am, who's a maths teacher in our school, is giving her feedback on what she feels about integration of ICT with maths.
Hello everyone, my name is Manjusha and I teach maths at SES Gurukul. Last year, Ankita came up with an idea to collaborate computational thinking with other subjects. Initially, we were all very skeptical because we did not know any sort of programming. But then, Ankita took us through some of the Scratch projects and immediately we saw potential to explain some of the mathematical concepts through Scratch. The first topic that we picked up was two-dimensional coordinate system, where I introduced to the students the 2D plane and x and y axis and how motions of up and down and left and right translate mathematically. The students then went on to build the logic for the program and were very excited when they got it right. It was a revelation for me, and since then we have collaborated on few other topics as well. It was a whole new way of teaching for me. Thank you.
Before ending my presentation, I would like to thank our principal Seema ma'am and the director of our school, Shubha ma'am, for motivating me for teaching computational thinking. It has not only helped our students to learn in a new way, but has also opened doors for us teachers to impart education in a whole new way. Thank you.